not now, Dorothy. We are counting our chicks.
But Dodo doesn't do it every day, just twice a week. And he can't catch her old cat anyway.
Dorothy, we are too busy for any fuss.
But I'm worried she will.
Oh, okay. Poor orphan. You know, she really ought to have someone to play with.
She has a dog. Besides, we all have to work out our own problems.
Oh, Hunk, what am I gonna do about Miss Gulch?
The woman from the farm to the west?
She scared Toto half to death today, shooing him away with her broom. I am afraid she will take Toto.
Don't worry, Dorothy. We'll put our heads together on this and use our brains.
It's not just brains that count. You got to use your heart, kid.
And your courage. You don't let that old woman try and bully you.
Oh, there she comes now.
Let's get back to work.
There you are, my pretty little neighbor. Where is your uncle?
Brains, heart, courage.
Ah, Mr. Gale.
Oh, afternoon, Miss Gulch.
I need to see your wife right away. It's about Dorothy.
Dorothy? What's she done?
I'll tell you what she's done. I can barely walk from the bite on my leg.
Dorothy bit you?
No, that scraggly little dog of hers.
No, Toto bit her.
Is that so?
Henry and I will make sure Dorothy knows not to go near your property again, Miss Gulch.
That dog's a menace to our community.
Oh, he isn't. Toto was just scared.
I'm taking him to the sheriff right now. That dog needs to be put away.
Oh no, I won't let you take him.
Give him to me. Oh, that's it. I'll be back with the sheriff's warrant. And until then, you better keep that girl under control. And her little dog too.
Listens. Nobody wants to help me. Might as well talk to scarecrows. But what about Dodo?
Not now, we're having a
crisis. She's gonna call the sheriff.
Not now,
your aunt's in the state.
You don't understand. Later, honey, you'll just have to wait.
Nobody understands me.
We can't afford to lose one chick.
My little dog's in danger. Take these out of the car. Should we reborn a chicken? Then they're paid attention.
Poor little orphan,
she's got to learn to earn her keep.
Henry,
just saying, well, come on, I hope you've got them in time.
All right, we'll get these in the house.
Come on, help me, you guys are stronger than me. That was scary, I thought it was gonna fall me.
Somebody has to listen.
Where's your gun?
Toto's in awful trouble.
Hold on, what is it, honey?
She's gonna call the sheriff.
Who is Miss Gulch?
Miss Gulch is taking Toto. She says she wants to kill him.
What happened this time, her cat again? Should we do what we did last time? When we were watering the crop?
We turned the hose on Miss Gulch. Should we do that again?
I'll get one that calls on the little dog too.
It's not funny, you guys. You play any more tricks, you'll only make it worse.
She's not gonna take it.
But she will.
Just wants to give you a fright.
No, she means it.
You wanna know her bark's worse than her bite.
Hickory, help me fix this.
Hickory, you be careful.
Nobody even listens.
Dorothy! Poor little kid,
I wish I knew to help her.
Yeah, I know what you mean.
Woo! Hey, I fixed it. Come on, let's get this hooked up to the barn.
The only one who really loves me, Toto. Gosh, there must be some place where we belong. A place where we're not in any trouble. Where we're safe. Where we're... Oh, Jiminy, what was that? It's her. It's Miss Gulch. Quick, hide.
That nasty little mongrel, that whiny little scoger. Repulsive little canine. It's time she learned a lesson.
Miss Gulch, she blows in from the west, like a real wicked witch sometimes.
Oh, howdy ma'am. My name is Professor Osman, and I invent technological wonders. I'm passing through on my way to the state fair.
Oh my! The state fair?
What a fine farm you have here. And any fine farm needs my new invention.
Ooh!
The Hydro-Oxide 4000 irrigation system. Allow me to demonstrate. It's right here in my bag. I think this goes here. And this should fit here. Yeah, this just needs a couple more seconds for the water to flow.
Oh, what a clever idea.
Oh, what nonsense. We don't have time or money for all that hoopla.
Oops. Well, gotta go. State fair coming. Hope to see you there, kid.
Dorothy, you run along now and find yourself a place where you won't be filling your head with any more crazy ideas or get yourself into any more trouble.
I wonder if there is such a place. There must be somewhere. Somewhere.
When all the world is a hopeless jumble and the raindrops tumble all around, heaven opens a magic lane. Looking up the skyway, there's a rainbow highway to be found, leading from my window pane to a place behind the sun, just a step beyond the rain.
Somewhere over
then oh why can't I? If happy little bluebirds fly
in Kansas anymore.
Are you a good witch or a bad witch?
Me? Why? I'm not a witch at all. I'm Dorothy from Kansas.
Oh, well, is that the witch?
Toto? No, this is my dog, Toto.
Well, I'm confused. The Munchkins call me because they said that a new witch has just dropped a house on the Wicked Witch of the East. And there's the house.
Huh?
And here you are. And those legs are all what's left of the Wicked Witch of the East.
Oh my!
And so, the Munchkins want to know if you are a good witch or a bad witch.
But I would never want to be a witch. Witches are mean and ugly. What was that?
The Munchkins. They are laughing. Because, you see, I am a witch. I'm Glinda, the good witch of the north. And these are the Munchkins who live in this Munchkin land. And you are their hero, my dear. It's all right. You all can come out and thank her.
Come out, wherever you are, and meet the young lady who fell from a star. She fell from the sky, she fell very far, and Kansas, she says, is the name of the star.
Kansas, she says, is the name of the star.
She brings you good news. When she fell out of Kansas, a miracle occurred.
It really was no miracle. What happened was just this. The wind began to pitch, the house to slitch, and suddenly the hinges started to unhitch. Just then,
wrench. The kitchen took a slinch. It landed on the wicked witch in the middle of a ditch, which was not a healthy situation for a wicked witch.
The house began to pitch. The kitchen took a slinch. It landed on the wicked witch in the middle of a ditch, which was not a healthy situation for a wicked witch, who began to twitch and was reduced to just a stitch. All but the once a wicked witch.
We thank you very sweetly, but doing it so neatly,
you've killed her so completely that we
thank you very sweetly.
Let the joyous news be spread, the wicked old witch at last is dead.
Ding dong, the witch is dead, bitch or witch, the wicked witch. Ding dong, the wicked witch is dead. Wake up, sleepy head, rub your eyes, get out of bed. Wake up, the wicked witch is dead. She's gone where the goblins go, below, below, below your home. Let's open up and sing and ring the bells out. Ding dong, the merry low, sing it high, sing it low. Let them know the wicked witch is dead.
Munchkin City, in the country of the land of Oz, I welcome you most regally.
But I've got to verify it legally to see,
to see
if she,
if she
is morally, ethically,
spiritually, physically,
positively, absolutely,
undeniably,
and reliably dead.
Coroner, I must have her. I've thoroughly examined her, and she's not only merely dead, she's really most sincerely dead.
Ding dong, the witch is dead, witch oh witch, the wicked witch. Ding dong, the wicked witch is dead. Wake up, the sleepy head, rub your eyes, get out of bed. Wake up, the wicked witch is dead. She's gone where the goblins go, below, below, below your home. Let's open up and sing and ring the bells out. Ding dong, the merry go, sing it high, sing it low. Let them know the wicked witch is dead.
Of the East. This is the Wicked Witch of the West, and she's worse than the other one was.
Who killed my sister? Who killed the Witch of the East? Was it you? Answer me!
Leave her alone!
So it was you, was it? You killed her?
No, no, it was an accident. I didn't mean to kill anybody. Really, it was an accident.
Oh, you didn't mean it, eh? An accident? Well, my pretty, I can cause accidents too. And this is how I do it.
Aren't you forgetting the ruby slippers?
Yes, the slippers. The slippers. The slippers are gone. Give them back to me, all right?
It's too late. There they are. Dorothy, step forward.
Please, give me those slippers. I am the only one who knows how to use them. Give them to me now. Give them back.
Keep that inside of them. Their magic must be very powerful, or she wouldn't want them so badly.
Stay out of this, Linda, or I'll fix you as well.
Oh, rubbish. You have no power here. Be gone if a house falls on you.
Very well. I'll be gone for now. But you better stay out of my way. And you, I'll get you, my pretty, and that little dog, too.
It's all right. She has gone. Y'all can get up. I'm afraid you've made a bad enemy of that witch. The sooner you get out of this land, the safer you'll be, my dear.
I would give anything to get home right now. But which way back to Kansas?
The only person who might know, my dear, would be the great, wonderful Wizard of Oz himself.
A wizard? What kind of wizard?
Oh, a very good, but a very mysterious wizard. He lives in the Emerald City. That's a long way from here. Did you bring your broomstick with you?
Broomstick? Why? I don't have any broomstick.
Well, then you will have to walk.
But which way do I go to get to Emerald City?
It's always best to start at the beginning, my dear.
Oh my!
The Munchkins will see you safely to the border of Munchkin Land.
But what happens if the witch comes back and...
Remember to never let those ruby slippers off your feet. Now, just follow the yellow brick road.
Now what was it she said?
Follow the yellow brick road.
Follow the yellow brick road.
Follow the yellow brick road.
Follow the yellow brick road. But the road splits are
directions. Now which way do we go, Toto?
That way is very nice.
Who said that?
It's also very nice down that way.
Did you say something? Well, did you or didn't you?
The trouble, I can't make up my mind.
Who, he? He hasn't got a brain.
Oh my, but you can talk.
Where I come from, people with no brains do an awful lot of talking.
Boo! Scat! Boo! Boo!
Ooh, I'm really scared.
Shoo, you two! Shoo! 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 Well, that's better. Shall we meet properly? I'm Dorothy Gale from Kansas.
I'm Scarecrow from... well, from this cornfield. How do you do?
I've never met a talking scarecrow before. What's the matter?
I'm stuck on this pole and it's very uncomfortable.
Oh my! Can I help you?
Ooh, be careful my insides don't fall out. Ooh! Did I scare you?
Of course not.
That's the problem. I'm a scarecrow and I don't even know how to scare. If I only had a brain, I would.
What would you do, Scarecrow? What would you do?
I could while away the hours, conferring with the flowers, consulting with the rain. And my head would be scratching, all my thoughts were busy hatching if I only had a brain. I'd unravel every riddle for any individual in trouble or in pain. With the thoughts I'd be thinking, I could be another Lincoln if I only had a brain. Oh, I could tell you why the ocean's near the shore. I could think of things I never thought before, and then I'd sit and think some more. My head awful of stuffing, my heart all full of pain. I would dance and be merry, life would be a dimmer dairy if I only had a brain. Things I can explain. Then perhaps I deserve you and be even worthy of you if I only had a brain.
Oh, that was wonderful, Scarecrow. You should come with me to Oz and ask the wizard to give you a brain.
Should I stay here or go to Oz? It's hard to know what to do.
What's the use of thinking about it when you haven't got a brain?
Yes, yes. Let's go, Scarecrow. Get you a brain and me back home.
So, we're off to see the wizard?
Mm-hmm.
Kevin Dorothy, I got this.
Boo! Who's this mindless, overstuffed
creature? Come along, Scarecrow. We don't want any of those apples.
What are you trying to say? My apples are not good enough? First, they want apples, then they don't want them. Can't they make up their minds? How dare you? Let's give it to them.
That's one good way to get some apples. Good going!
What is that? Why, it's a man! A man made out of tin! He's an oil can. Oh, there it is. Where would you like me to put it?
I think he said mouth.
Oh, thank you. Arms, please. Oh, this is wonderful. I've held that axe up for ages.
However, did you get like this?
Well, a year ago, I was chopping the tree over there and minding my own business. Suddenly, it started to rain.
Oh my!
Legs, elbows, knees, right in the middle of a chop. I rusted solid. I've been this way since.
Well, you're perfect now.
No, I'm not. Bang on my chest if you think I'm perfect. Go ahead, bang on it.
Beautiful. What an echo.
It's empty. The tinsmith forgot to give me a heart.
No heart?
No heart.
Said a tin man, rattled in his gibbs. To a straw man, sat him very hard. Oh, the Lord gave him tin ribs, but forgot to put a heart.
An empty kettle, he should be on his mettle, and yet I'm blown apart. Just because I'm presuming that I could be kind of human if I only had a heart. I'd be tender, I'd be gentle, and awful sentimental regarding love and art. I'd be friends with the sparrows and the boy who shoots the arrows if I only had a heart. Picture me, a balcony above, a voice sings low. Where for other Romeo, I hear a beat. How sweet, just to register emotion, jealousy, devotion, and really feel the part. I could stay young and chipper, and I'd lock it with a zipper if I only had a heart.
could stay young and chipper, and I'd lock it with a zipper. If I only had a heart.
So, will you come to the Emerald City with us and ask the wizard to give you a heart?
Why? I don't know. That's a long and dangerous journey, and it might rain along the way.
Oh, I'll keep the oil can handy.
To Oz?
To Oz. You didn't forget about me, did you? I haven't forgotten about you. And I haven't forgotten about those ruby slippers either.
Helping the young lady along, are you, my fine gentleman?
Well, stay away from her, or I'll fill you full of bees. And you, Scarecrow, I'll play a little fireball, eh, Scarecrow?
Fire!
And as for you and that pesky little dog of yours, I'll see to it that you never get to Oz. I'll get you, my pretty. I'll get you.
Maybe we shouldn't go to Oz after all.
But I need to get back home. And we need to get you a brain.
Well, if you think so.
And we need to get you a heart.
Well, if you feel so.
Oh, you're both the two best friends anybody ever had. And it's funny, but I feel as if I've known you my whole life. But I couldn't have. Could I?
To see the wizard?
To see the Wizard of Oz.
Wild animals?
We might.
Animals that eat straw?
Some, but mostly lions and tigers and bears.
Lions and tigers
and bears.
Lions and tigers and bears.
Oh my.
Lions and tigers and bears.
Oh my.
Lions and tigers and bears.
Oh my.
Put them up. Put up your dukes. I'll fight you. I'll fight you both if you want. I'll fight you with one paw tied behind my back. I'll fight you standing on one foot.
Go away and leave us alone.
Oh, you scared, huh? You shivering junkyard. Oh. Come on and fight, you lopsided bag of hay. What about you, Pee-wee? I'll get you too. Oh, what did you do that for? I didn't bite him.
No, but you tried to. And it's bad enough you're picking on strawmen. But then you go around picking on poor dogs.
Is my nose bleeding?
Oh my, what a fuss you're making. Picking on things weaker than you are. Why, you're nothing but a great big coward.
You're right. I am a coward. I haven't any courage at all. I haven't slept in weeks.
Why don't you try counting sheep?
Oh, he can't count sheep. He's afraid of them.
Yeah, he is even afraid of us.
Not that way, this way.
Life is sad, believe me, Missy, when you're born to be so clumsy without the vim and verve. But I could show my prowess, be a lion or a mouse if I only had the nerve. I'm afraid there's no denying, I'm just a dandelion, a fate I don't deserve. But I could change my habits, never more be scared of rabbits if I only had the nerve. Some more. I would show the dinosaurus who's king around the forest a king they better serve. But I could change my habits, never more be scared of rabbits if I only had the nerve. Some more. I would show the dinosaurus who's king around the forest a king they better serve. I'd be brave as a blizzard, you'd be gentle as a lizard, you'd be clever as a gizzard. If the wizard is a wizard who will serve, then you're sure to get a brain, a heart, a home, the nerve.
Do you think the Wizard of Oz could help him too?
I don't see why not. We're on our way to see the Wizard of Oz, now to get him a heart
and him a brain.
And I'm sure he could give you some courage.
Oh, to be brave.
Roar! Woo him!
Shouldn't he be a little louder?
Come on now, a little louder.
Oh, to be king of the forest. Roar!
Come on now, give it all you've got.
Show me the king of the forest.
I will show him who's the king of the forest.
Oh, to be the bravest lion of all. Roar!
Yes, let's go get you some courage.
And me a brain.
And me a heart.
And me back home.
You'll have to see the wizard, the life of Wizard of Oz. You'll find he is the Wizard of Wiz, the fabulous Wizard of Oz. If ever a wonderful Wizard of Oz, the Wizard of Oz is fine because of the wonderful things he does. You'll have to see the wizard.
These are poppies. But what's that fragrance?
You're on the top, you're on the top.
Dorothy, give me your hand.
I can't go on anymore. I'm so sleepy. I have to rest for just a minute.
Oh, this is terrible. It must be some kind of spell. It must be the Wicked Witch. What will we do? Help!
Call away! No one will help you this time. After all, I am the Wicked Witch. Those slippers are mine now, my pretty. Fly off and take those winged friends with you and fetch me those slippers.
I am on it, most wickedest witch.
Oh, Dorothy. Poor Dorothy.
And now the lion. He's sleeping too.
Help us! Help! Help us!
I hear you, Scarecrow.
Stop.
Oh, look! There it is at last! The Emerald City!
We're off to see the wizard, the wonderful Wizard of Oz!
Oh, my!
Oh, wow!
Oh, don't do that.
Can't you read?
Read what?
The notice. Why, it's as plain as the nose on your face. It's here. 1 minute, please.
Bell out of order. Please knock.
Well, that's more like it. Now, state your business.
We want to see the wizard!
The wizard? But nobody's ever seen the Great Oz. Well, I've never seen him.
Well then, how do you know there is one?
Because you're wasting my time.
Please, sir. We must see the Wizard of Oz. The Goodrich of the North sent me.
Goodrich of the North? Well, prove it.
Look, she's wearing the ruby slippers she gave her.
Oh, so she is.
Why didn't you say that in the first place? Come on, Im.
Welcome to the city of Oz, my dear.
Come on, friends.
Let's have it.
Guard!
The great and powerful Oz will not see you or anyone else today.
But please, sir, we must see the Wizard of Oz.
Orders are, nobody can see the great Oz. Go home. The wizard says, go away.
But she's Dorothy.
The witch is Dorothy? Well, that makes a difference. I'll announce you at once.
I am the great Wizard of Oz. Come forward.
Tell me when it's over.
Who are you?
If you please, I'm Dorothy, and I've come to ask you.
Silence! The great and powerful Oz knows why I've come. Step forward. Tin Man!
Oh, that's me.
Dare you come to me for a heart? Do you, you clinking, clanking collection of junk?
Yes, sir. To your honor, you see, we were walking down the yellow brick road.
Quiet! And you, Scarecrow, you have the nerve to ask for a brain, you big fluffy sack of hay?
Yes, yes, your honor.
Enough! And you, lion!
I think I'll wait outside. I'm too scared.
You ought to be ashamed of yourself. He came to you for help.
I have every intention of granting your requests. But first, you must prove yourselves worthy by performing a very small task. You must bring me the broomstick of the Wicked Witch of the West. Now, be gone.
But, how could we do that?
Bring me her broomstick and I will grant your requests. Now, go!
This witch's den is really creepy.
I'd turn back if I were us.
Stay close and watch out for the witch's broom.
I think this is a bad idea.
Misguided, it's all so one-sided. That dim-witted girl dares to tangle with me. She's prissy, she's clueless, and I want her shoeless. I'll show her how fiendishly mean I can be. I want those shoes to establish his dues. Number one, from the east to the west. Then I'll be complete with the world my feet, and red always suited me best. I know I hold sway over all I sway, but I now need a much bigger deal. The shoes are the key to the making of me, so find her and bring her to heel. When I get that footwear from her, and footwear it could have been, should have been, right from the start, my power will grow. It'll blossom and flow through the world, through the years, and straight to my heart. We all like to dance, so now here's your chance. You'll dance till your very last gasp. Just say, Berowet, you'll falter and sweat, and stumble right into my grasp. You'll find you can stop as you dance till you drop, and stumble right into my grasp. Enjoy your dance, my pretty, and now, my monkey.
peace. My darlings, yes, it's time, long last, go and do your work. Now off you go and mop up the mess. I want that little girl and a mangy little dog, but most of all, I want my slippers! Now go, fly, fly, fly!
Give me those ruby red slippers, or you don't want to see your precious little dog harmed, do you?
Go ahead, you can have your old slippers back. Please, please give me back Toto.
I knew you'd see reason. That power is too strong. I'll have to think of another way to get there. But I can't wait forever for those shoes. You see, you don't have much time to live. Eeny, meeny, miny, moe. Who will be the first to go? Lion?
Oh, no, 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 no.
Scarecrow?
Oh, no, no, no.
Girl?
No, no, no.
Tin Man?
No, no.
No, no. My broomstick has chosen Scarecrow. God, oh, no, get him here.
No. No.
Come here, you scarecrow, come along!
Dorothy, the bucket of water!
Oh, you little bird!
rat! Look what you've done! I'm melting! I'm melting! Oh, what a wall! What a wall! Who could have thought such a sweet little girl like you could destroy my beautiful wickedness? Oh, I'm melting! I'm melting!
You destroyed her!
I didn't mean to. It was just that Scarecrow was on fire and...
Hail to Dorothy! The Wicked Witch is dead!
Have the broomstick?
Yes.
Take it with you.
Oh, thank you so much. Now we can take it to the Wizard of Oz and he will tell me how to get back home. Let's go.
So, you've come back.
Yes, sir. We've done what you asked us to and brought the broomstick for the Wicked Witch of the West.
But how?
We melted her, and so we'd like you to keep the promise that you made to us.
Well, now I'll have to think about that. Go away and come back tomorrow.
No, but I want to go home now.
I said tomorrow.
You had plenty of time already.
Do you presume to criticize the Great Oz? You are lucky that I'm giving you audience tomorrow instead of 20 years from now.
Who are you?
Well, I am the Great Oz. Pay no attention to the man behind the curtain. Now go away, the great and powerful.
Why? You're just a man. A very bad man.
Oh, humbug. I am a man. But I'm not a bad man, my dear. I am a very good man. I'm just a very bad wizard.
But what about our requests? My brain.
And my heart.
What about my courage?
And sending Dorothy back home.
Why? Anybody can have a brain. But they have one thing that you don't have. A diploma. Therefore, by the authority vested in me, I confer upon you the honorary degree of PhD.
What's PhD?
Why, it's Doctor of Thinkology.
The sum of the square root of any two sides of an isosceles triangle equals the square root of the other sides. Oh joy! Oh rapture! I've got a brain! Woo! How can I ever thank you enough?
No need to thank me, my friend. And as for you, my fine friend, just because you run away from danger does not mean that you have no courage. So for your bravery against the Wicked Witch, I award you the Triple Cross.
Oh, shucks.
And as for you, my galvanized friend, you want a heart. Hearts will never be practical until they are made unbreakable.
But I still want one.
Yes. Now remember, a heart is not judged by how much you love, but by how much you are judged by others.
What about Dorothy?
I'm sure there's nothing in that box that could help me.
Why, Dorothy? You've had the power to return home all along.
Huh? I have?
It's true, Dorothy. You've always had the power to go back to Kansas.
Then why didn't you tell her before?
Because she wouldn't have believed me. She had to learn it for herself.
Learned? Well, what have you learned, Dorothy?
I think that if I ever go looking for my heart's desire again, I won't look any further than my own backyard. Because everything I will ever need is right there. Is that right?
That's all it is. Now that you've found it for yourself, those magic slippers will take you home in 2 seconds.
Toto, too?
Toto, too?
Oh, this is too wonderful to be true. I love you all. Don't cry, Tin Man. You'll rust up.
My heart is breaking.
Goodbye, Lion. I'm gonna miss the way you used to holler for help before you found your courage.
I think I'm gonna holler a bit now.
I think I'm gonna miss you most of all, Scarecrow.
I'll think about you always.
I'm ready.
Okay, close your eyes and tap your heels together 3 times and think to yourself, there's no place like home. There's no place like home. There's no place like home.
There's no place like home. There's no place like home. There's no place like home.
Fire!
anybody home? I just drove by because I heard that a little girl got caught by the storm. She seems alright now.
She's got quite a big bump on her head. For a minute there, we thought she's going to leave us.
Oh, but I did leave you, Uncle Henry.
And I tried to get back home for days and days and days and days and days.
It was just a bad dream, Dorothy.
Well, see you around, kid.
Remember me, your old friend Hunk?
And me, Hickory?
And you couldn't forget my face, could you?
Oh, but it wasn't a dream. It was a place. And I, and you, and you, you, and you. You all were there. But you couldn't have been there. Could you?
We dream a lot of silly things.
Oh, but it wasn't a dream. It was truly a real place. And I remember, some of it wasn't very nice, but most of it was beautiful. Doesn't anybody believe me?
Oh, of course we do, Dorothy.
But anyway, Toto, we're home. And you all are here now. And I'm never going to leave you. Ever. Because I love you all. And Aunt Em, there's no place like home.
There's no place like home.
And now, ladies and gentlemen, the show begins. Please put your hands together for our sensational seven.
Yeah.
Ladies and gentlemen, it's been a fabulous evening, and I think our wonderful cast needs a huge round of applause all over again. For all our students, the main cast right here in front of us, all the dancers, all the singers, the fantastic choir that we have had, it's been a great evening, and I'm sure they have, as you realize, they have put in a huge amount of work over the last several weeks, and we have been able to really see their performance this evening. Behind the children, of course, there's the entire DBIS staff, those who train them in the acting, those who train them in the singing, those who train them in the dancing. Let's hear it for the entire DBIS team. Congratulations also to those who handled the costumes, the makeup, all the other props that we see on the stage. A very special thanks to Neil Banks and his crew for the stage, for the lights, for the sounds. Neil, it's been a fantastic evening. Thank you so much. And now, ladies and gentlemen, allow me to call on stage the man behind the show, the director of our musical, the real Wizard of Oz, Father Ajoy Fernandez. Can we have Father Ajoy on stage? Over the last several weeks, Father Ajoy has really been the backbone of this entire performance, right from selecting the cast, personally training all the main actors, overseeing all the choreography and the singing, spending several hours in the studio getting the track recorded. Every bit of the performance that we have had this evening is thanks to the very, very magical hands of Father Ajoy Fernandez. We are extremely and deeply grateful to him for what he has done for the school and for our children. And I'm sure at this Oscar-winning moment, we would love to hear Father Ajoy.
I'm really overwhelmed. I don't think a single person could ever put this together. It's the work of the entire team, including the children who've braved so many practices all these days. So to everybody, thank you very much, and thanks for the supportive group of parents for being around. Thank you, dear parents, also for putting up with all the changes and schedules that were required in order to put this play together. We appreciate it very much. Thank you.
Once again, a huge round of applause for our director of the musical, Father Ajoy Fernandez. Ladies and gentlemen, my dear friends, as we come to the end of this Thanksgiving Day, thanks to each one of you for being with us. Thanks to our chief guest, Father Elson. Thanks to Father Godfrey D'Souza, our provincial, and all the other dignitaries who have been here with us this evening.